I find it ironic how we tend to write people off while God is the one writing their stories. Ironic how our finite minds unknowingly undermine the work of the author and finisher of our faith, who illustrated the beauty in this place we live in called Earth, how man was intricately formed from the dust and the dirt, the fact that he finished our stories before birth, and the God who blotted out our transgressions. It's interesting how he put his stories and ultimately his glory into question. And just when we thought we could predict their outcome, God displayed an unexpected twist to show us that we were wrong about what we thought was weak and useless, because in his script he actually uses what we think is weak to deem us as foolish. See, consider me, age 3. Stood out like a black sheep, a little boy who had issues with his speech. It was seemingly predestined that it would be hard for me to speak, as I would endure my classmates and their hurtful critiques, because they failed to understand that God just made me unique. I had doctors and dentists telling me that I would be tongue-tied, and without surgery, my tongue would stay tied. But before I had any knowledge of spoken word, I had parents who spoke his word. And instead of panicking, they prayed and reminded themselves and I that I was fearfully and wonderfully made, and reassured me that God was the potter and I was the clay. So by God's grace, the physical limitations to my voice have gone astray, but the effect that it had on me mentally remained. See, I actually grew up hating the sound of my own voice. So I began to be quiet by choice, because I was afraid of people listening to what I perceived to be hindering. Fast forward to high school, when for the first time I was told that my voice was bold by a speech class teacher. And also for the first time when I realized that because of Christ, I was made a new creature. See, my identity wasn't found in my insecurity, but found in the one who bore my iniquity. A man who possessed no beauty that we should desire him, no majesty to his frame. A man who took on our shame, a man who took on our pain. Even though we like sheep have gone astray, by oppression and judgment he was taken away, so that one day we may recognize him as the life, the truth, and the way. A man rejected and despised, but yet he took on our punishment when he hung on the cross and died. And I also remember being introduced to Exodus chapter 4, verse 10 through 11 for the first time. Moses, who stood in the presence of the Almighty God, the self-proclaimed I am that I am, and asked him, "Who am I? For my speech is not eloquent and I've always been tongue-tied." But God replied back and said, "Moses, put your insecurity to the side, because I will be right by your side. For who gives someone the ability to speak? Is it not I? I will protect you, so I want you to be my mouthpiece, because I have already given you the ability to speak." And from that day forward, I realized that the very thing that I hated was essentially the very thing that God created. See, the very thing that you think you lack could also be the very thing that God uses for impact. Listen, God already finished your story while others are still trying to guess your ending. And even though their thoughts towards you were insensitive and condescending, there is a God in heaven ascending that is tender to your heart that he's mending. Because that instrument he will use to give harmony to this world, it's you that he's sending. So to that boy who was once told by his teachers that he would be a troublemaker because they forgot that the words have power, remember that caterpillars will one day turn into butterflies. And one day you will flutter by like those eagles and soar, because despite what they saw in you, God actually had more in store. See, what others may have ignored, God will soon restore. And for those who were put in a box, remember That box that they tried to put you in is just your treasure chest, containing God's riches and his manifest bless. Treasures you already possess, while others said you were X. And for those who may have written off someone as hopeless, remember that we were all once black sheep made white because we were washed in the blood of the Lamb. We are all God's masterpiece, and because of Christ, we can now do the good things that God has planned. So I stand here boldly saying, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice, because you never know when he might just use your voice.